हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडेज़ केमिस्ट्री क्लास यू विल लर्न अबाउट डिफरेंट मेथड्स यूज्ड फॉर सेपरेशन ऑफ लिक्विड गैस मिक्सचर्स एंड सेपरेशन ऑफ गैस गैस मिक्सचर्स. सो लेट्स सी द फर्स्ट टॉपिक, दैट इज़ द सेपरेशन ऑफ लिक्विड गैस मिक्सचर्स. अ लिक्विड गैस मिक्सचर इज सेपरेटेड बाय सिंपल बॉइलिंग मेथड. Dissolved gas escape from the liquid on heating or boiling, and this principle is based on the fact that the solubility of a gas in a liquid decreases with an increase in temperature. For an example, drinking water contains some dissolved gases, and on boiling, air escape out and the boiled water becomes tasteless. Now the next one, separation of gas-gas mixtures. For the separation of gas-gas mixtures, mainly three methods are being used. The first method, diffusion, second, solvent extraction, and the third one, liquefaction. So first see, diffusion method. This method depends upon the difference in the densities of the gases present in the mixture. The lighter gas diffuses more rapidly as compared to the heavier one. And the example, a mixture of hydrogen and oxygen is separated by this method. In diffusion method, two gases, means a mixture, is passed through a porous partition. As you can see in the picture, that porous partition, this membrane acts like a porous partition, and lighter gas diffuses more rapidly than heavier gas, and this underlying principle is based on the difference in the densities of gases. As same you can see in the picture, the mixture is passed through a porous membrane or partition, and the lighter one, they passed off, means the densities, the gas which has low density, they got separated, means retented and permeate, means lighter one and the heavier gas particles, which they are separated when they passed through a porous membrane. Now the next method is solvent extraction. This method depends upon the fact that some gases dissolved in water or some other solvent, while some gases do not, or they are very less soluble. For an example, a mixture of carbon dioxide and carbon monoxide can be separated by this method, as carbon dioxide is highly soluble in water and carbon monoxide is sparingly soluble, means it is less soluble. Now the next and the last method, that is liquefaction method. This method is based upon the fact that some gases like ammonia, carbon dioxide, they liquefy easily at high pressure and low temperature, while others are not easily liquefied. So it's easier for these two gases to separate. Example, a mixture of ammonia and nitrogen can be separated by this liquefaction method. For more detail, just go through your textbook. This is the last topic of your chapter 3, elements, compounds and mixtures. So now you will write the exercise question answers in your chemistry notebook. And today's homework is explain different methods used to separate gas-gas mixtures. Along with the exercise questions, write this answer also in your chemistry notebook. Thank you.